We are asked to solve and check the given linear equation in one variable. To solve a linear equation means to determine the value of the variable that satisfies the equation or makes the equation true. To do this, we must isolate the variable on one side of the equation. Looking at the given equation, notice how the equation contains three fractions, which means we do have an option to multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator in order to clear the fractions from the equation before solving. In this video, we will first solve the equation in its current form and then come back and solve it again by first clearing the fractions from the equation just to show we do get the same answer. So the given equation is 3/4 x minus 1/6 equals 1/2. Leaving the equation in this form, the first step is to add or subtract to isolate the variable term. Here the variable term is 3/4 x, which means we need to undo this minus 1/6 by adding 1/6 to both sides of the equation. On the left, negative 1/6 plus 1/6 is 0. The left side is now 3/4 x. We have 3/4 x equals, and now we need to find the sum of 1/2 and 1/6. To add the fractions, we must obtain a common denominator. The least common denominator is 6, which means we need to write 1/2 as an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 6, and therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. 1/2 is equivalent to 3/6. We now have 3/6 plus 1/6, which equals 4/6. But 4 and 6 do share a common factor of 2, and therefore we can simplify. If we divide 4 by 2 and 6 by 2, we can see the fraction of 4/6 simplifies to 2/3. So going back to the equation, we now have 3/4 x equals 2/3. The last step is to multiply or divide to solve for the variable. And because 3/4 x means 3/4 times x, we are probably thinking we should divide both sides by 3/4. But remember, dividing by a fraction is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal. And therefore, instead of dividing both sides by 3/4, we will multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of 3/4, which is 4/3. On the left, 4/3 times 3/4 is equal to 1. Or if we need to show the simplifying, there's 1, 4, and 4 here and here. And there's 1, 3, and 3 here and here, giving us a product of 1 times 1, which is 1, and 1 times x is x. We have x equals. On the right side, nothing simplifies, and therefore we multiply the numerators and denominators. 4/3 times 2/3 is 8/9. The solution to the equation is x equals 8/9. Now let's go back and solve the equation again by first clearing the fractions from the equation. Looking at the denominators of the fractions, the least common denominator is 12, because 12 is the least common multiple of 4, 6, and 2. Which means to clear the fractions from the equation, we will take the optional step and multiply both sides of the equation by 12. This gives us 12 times the quantity 3/4 x minus 1/6 equals 12 times 1/2. Distributing on the left, we have 12 times 3/4 x minus 12 times 1/6 equals 12 times 1/2. And let's write 12 as a fraction with a denominator of 1. And now let's simplify before multiplying. 4 and 12 share a common factor of 4. There's 1, 4, and 4, and 3 4s and 12. This is now 3 times 3 times x, which is 9x. We have 9x minus, again, simplifying, there's 1, 6, and 6, and 2 6s and 12. This is now 2 times 1, which is 2. On the right side, again, simplifying, there's 1, 2, and 2, and 6 2s and 12. This is now 6 times 1, which is 6. Solving this equation, we first add or subtract to isolate 9x. To undo the subtraction, we add 2 to both sides. Simplifying, negative 2 plus 2 is 0. We now have 9x equals 8. last step is to undo this multiplication by dividing both sides by 9. Simplifying, 9 divided by 9 is 1. 1 times x is x. We have x equals 8/9. So notice how we do get the same solution by first clearing the fractions from the equation. Let's also take the time to check our solution. To check the solution, we need to verify that if we substitute 8/9 for x, it will satisfy the equation or make the equation true. Performing the substitution gives us 3/4 times 8/9 minus 1/6 equals 1/2. We begin by simplifying the left side of the equation. Before multiplying, we simplify. 3 and 9 share a common factor of 3. 1, 3, and 3, and 3 threes and 9. 4 and 8 share a common factor of 4. There's 1, 4, and 4, and 2 4s and 8. We now have 1 times 2/3, which is 2/3, giving us 2/3 minus 1/6 equals 1/2. To determine the difference, we need to obtain a common denominator. The least common denominator is 6. We need to write 2/3 as an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 6, which means we multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. 2/3 is equivalent to 4/6. 4/6 minus 1/6 equals 1/2. And 4/6 minus 1/6 is 3/6. And 3/6 does simplify to 1/2. 1/2 equals 1/2 is true. Verifying the solution is correct. I hope you found this helpful.